Welcome to our discussion on financial accounting. In this session, we will try to understand the financial statements preparation with the employee stock options. Let us take an example to understand that. Suppose this is the balance sheet of a company on 31st March 2009 with the assets and the corresponding sources. Let us put them on the Excel. On 31st March, they had plant, they had stock, an investment of 500,000. So therefore, plant, investment, and stock, okay, and stock of 200,000. So the total assets are 1,000,000, and the corresponding sources are. Corresponding sources are capital 100,000 and loan of 200,000 and the balance of the reserves. So the capital 100,000, loan 200,000 and the balance is reserve. This is on 31st March 2009. On 1st April, the company decides to issue the ESOPs, okay, makes an issue of ESOPs. Let us see the transaction. On 1st April, they issued the stock options to the eligible employees and the grant date is on 1st April 2009. The shares are issued like this of 10 at an exercise price of 80. And on that day, the market price is 100 and the vesting period is 200. Now, this is where we have to understand the accounting value of ESOP. Okay, the accounting value of ESOP is either intrinsic value, or the fair value, Intrinsic value is the excess of the market price over the exercise price. In this case, it is 100 minus 80, so it is 20. The fair value is decided on the basis of the valuation models. Okay, valuation models. But in this case, in this example, we are taking the value of ESOP as the intrinsic value, and that is the excess of market price over the market price or the exercise price, and you are issuing the eligible employees are issued. So let us assume that you are issuing 1,000 shares. Okay, suppose 1,000 ESOPs. So if you are issuing 1,000 ESOPs on this date, 1,000 ESOPs. So the value of ESOP 1,000 into 20, that is 20,000. Okay, and what to do with this 20,000? According to the guidance issued by the SEBI, the accounting for ESOP, that the accounting value contribution per year will be 20,000 divided by 2, that is 10,000. Now let's go back to the Excel. So on the date of the issue, I'm continuing with the same assets, okay, on the same assets and the same sources too, and same sources, but a new liability or a new asset corresponding to that will be shown as ESOP payable, and the corresponding asset will be the deferred employee cost, that is 20,000. That is 20,000. So 20,000 is the 20,000 is the value of ESOP shown to be shown in the books of account. Observe this. So there is a deferred employee expense and ESOP. And ESOP, or the deferred employee expense, will be amortized equally over the vesting period. Now let us see the transactions. The other transactions of this enterprise, they sold 40% of the stock for 100,000. Let us assume it for cash. Okay, for cash. So the sales is 100,000. The sales is 100,000, and it is for cash. Okay, it is for cash. So cash, because we are selling it not on credit but for cash, and the corresponding expense for this sales is 40% of the goods. So 0.40 of the goods sold. So the stock will come down by 80,000. Okay. What else? The other transactions are, during the period, the expenses are 10% of the sales. So other expenses 10% of the sales. So 0.10, and you paid for that, you paid those expenses. So expenses 10,000 is paid immediately. No other information given. However, we have to charge depreciation, and to understand depreciation in this example, see, the plant value cost is 600,000, accumulated depreciation is 300,000, the life of the plant is already exhausted, is 5 years, so let us assume it is 300,000 by 5 is the depreciation, that is 60,000 is depreciation. So 60,000 is depreciation, so the value of the plant will reduce by 60,000. And you have taken there is a loan sitting there on the balance sheet of 10%, so you have to pay interest of 10% loan, so therefore 0.10, and so we pay the interest, assuming that the entire interest is paid, no outstanding expense. But this deferred employee expense has to be, I'll write down DEE, or deferred employee expense, that is 20,000 divided by 2. So at the end of the year, the deferred employee expense will come down to 10,000. So all other expenses taken care. So the total expenses for the period, is 180,000. So therefore, there is a loss of 80,000 during the period, and the loss will be, if no information is given, the loss will be adjusted with the reserves. So the reserves will become 70,000 plus 80,000. Cash in hand, if you see the cash outflow is 30,000. The outflow is 30,000. inflow is only 100,000, so 100,000 minus 30,000, okay? And this cash in hand will appear in the asset side of the balance sheet. So cash in hand is 70,000. So cash in hand at the end of the period. No change in the investments, no change in the capital, no change in the loan, no change in the ESOP people, so your balance sheet tally. So the most important thing here in this question, we wanted to drive in the importance of ESOP. So the accounting value of ESOP, is a market price, which is 100 to recap. The exercise price is 80. So therefore, value of the ESOP or intrinsic value of the ESOP is 20. And since we are giving 1,000 ESOPs options, so therefore the total value is 20,000. The total value is 20 × 1,000, so 20,000. So if you observe this, the deferred employee expense is a result of the ESOP which have been issued, and the accounting value of ESOP has to be shown, and the ESOP payable will be the corresponding liability, and ESOP will be adjusted, amortized equally. So amortization will be divided by 2, so therefore amortization will be at the end, the value of the deferred revenue, deferred employee expense will be 10,000, and the deferred employee expense amortized will be shown in the income statement. Just to recap and move ahead, that the ESOP will be shown like this. Okay, the deferred expenses are shown in the income statement, and the ESOP is shown in the balance sheet on the sources side. So that was the focus of this example, was the preparation of the financial statement when the company